medicine and how it's connected to medieval. Basically, it doesn't connect it at all. So, in this year, we just decided to try how medical use case can be fitted into this community, and how can we connect information retrieval, media evaluation guys, and our medical research. And why we think it's important? Because basically there is no existing good connection between people who are working on medical imaging and people who are doing normal information retrieval and image analysis. Of course, you can find a lot of research which is about processing of CT scans, processing of ultrasound images, but not for normal medical imaging. And one of the reasons of that is because, well, mainly because of privacy issues. You can easily get CT or ultrasound images, but not normal images from inside of our body or whatever. So our goal is to bring doctors, IT guys, and make them work together. And this task was inspired by our MIND project, in which we're trying to do all this. So yeah, maybe you already seen this slide, but yeah, anyway. Our human body, and especially our gastrointestinal tract, can be affected by multiple diseases. And screening of that tract and finding these lesions and all the things happening inside of our gastrointestinal tract is very important. So, why it's important? Because it's very consuming, it can affect you, it's very time consuming, it's expensive, it can affect your health if you miss some polyp or bleeding or whatever, so you just can die. And currently, these gastrointestinal devices, endoscopes and capsule pills producers, they are not providing any kind of good working software to detect all these lesions. So you can expect only bleeding detection, and basically it's all. And there is a lot of ongoing research in this area, but no one really achieved any great results yet. Yeah, maybe this is because our body is very different. And these lesions are quite hard to detect. So yes, and this is just an example of statistics. So as you can see, for example, colorectal cancer is very dangerous things. And a lot of countries affected by this, and a lot of people dying yearly. And for example, in Norway, it's most common reason of dying for men and second for women. So it should be beaten somehow in the near future to improve quality of life. So for this doctor doing basically endoscopic procedure using normal endoscopes, which are just inserted into your body from up and from bottom. So it's not pleasant for patients, it's painful, it's stressful, and yeah, nobody wants to do it. So it's not possible to scale this procedure to do nationwide screening. So some kind of methods should be developed to make it works better nowadays. Yeah, and also to train the doctor properly to be able to detect all these different small, big things that can be easily misclassified in these procedures. It required from 2 to 3 years in special training centers, so it's very expensive. So there's a big shortage of doctors in that area. So our goal is basically develop some kind of automated system. Not only our goal, it's like, as I said, many research team working in this area nowadays. And second goal is to move toward so-called capsule endoscopy, and we modern kind of investigation. You just full of capsule, it goes through your body, film it, and yeah, you can get images or video out of your gastrointestinal tract. And next, you can it should be video, but it doesn't work. Maybe it works. No, it's PDF, whatever. Yeah, if you really, yeah, it's working. So this is a real video from capsule pill, so you can see what, yeah, it's a small bowel, I think. Yeah, something like this. And this is some case of bleeding. So yeah, it's really important to, as I said, introduce national live screening. And for this, so it's some kind of problem here. Yeah. And as I said, our big goal is to develop a combined system which can be used both for normal endoscopy and for capsule endoscopy, which will allow to detect lesions, do it in real time, with high recall precision, and because it's required for any kind of medical use cases. And very important part of that is automated report generation, because it's very time consuming for doctors to just write and describe all things. So we would like to combine it, detection and report generation. So yes, this is just a short, small overview of our system. So what do we really need for this system? We need medical knowledge. We need to extract this knowledge and transfer it into some kind of machine form understandable for computer, for using whatever methods, deep learning or machine learning or any kind of other algorithmic approaches. We need to build an analysis system which takes input, training data, and just classify all the frames and generate the report finally. So what is common challenges for this area is very bad image quality. Basically, it's caused by bad lenses used in these devices. It's object can be too close, too far away from camera, so we can be covered by any substances. Lighting is typically very bad, or it can be overlighted or underlighted, so it's very hard to detect objects compared to normal object recognition and information retrieval approaches. Yeah, and also, as I said, there is no any support for report generation in existing systems. So here's example how it's challenging to spot all these things. Just give me a second. So basically, this is polypary. As you can see, these two, there is no such a big difference to surrounding tissue, so it's really hard to detect what is there. Is it right? Just a normal tissue like this, or it's polyp, which should be removed. Yeah. So this is why we decided to set up this subtask and to basically check if this topic is interesting for information retrieval and medieval community, or it's completely off track. So we introduced our task consists of different subtasks. First is detection. Main goal of this subtask is to just make multi-class classification of the data set using training data set and test data set, and with the second goal to minimize amount of training data used, because in medical scenario it's not likely to get a lot of images of some disease, and for some cases you can get 10, 100 maximum examples. Yeah, second subtask is efficient detection, which should be the same as first one, but with main focus on speeding up the approach, so to make detection as fast as possible. Next, we try to introduce fair, efficient detection subtask. In this subtask, we are thinking about running all algorithms on the same hardware to just compare how we can perform and just do absolutely fair comparison of performance. And the report generation, which should be experimental, so just generate some text report based on information provided. Yeah. So for this we created two data sets, published it open source at MMC's this year MMC's conference, and yeah, these data sets are available online, and one of these data sets used in this task, it's called Quasar. It consists of 8,000 images, 1,000 image per each class. So we just split it with all these images into group of two. One is development data set. We published it with annotations, and other images were just randomized and published as test data set. pretty fast. So it's quite, it's not low and not high amount of data. Okay. It should be, it's enough. So finally, for this task, we got 12 teams registered and requested access to the data. 5 teams were submitted the results from different countries. Basically, so we got 46 submissions in total, but our subtasks were not so successful as we expected. So for detection, we got all submissions required to evaluate participants' results. For efficient detection, well, teams didn't submit any different data, so we don't really, we can't really compare, like, can we provide more efficient algorithms or no. And yeah, for the efficient detection, no source code were submitted. And report generation, we decided to do not go with these tasks because, yeah, it wasn't unclear even for us how to process the data and how, what we should ask participants to submit. So, yeah. We find out what participants use a lot of different techniques to achieve multi-class detection. So it's really interesting for us. And what is more surprising, as a main matrix, we have used multi-class visualization of Mathieu's correlation coefficient, which is useful for multi-class detection, and especially it's useful for unbalanced data sets. In our case, it was balanced, but for the future, yeah, we will stick to this. So, and the results. Surprisingly, all teams achieved very good results for first try. We were really impressed how good they are. So this is like official final table, and yeah, as you can see, all teams was much better when random and zero reference classification performance metrics. So yeah, similar as our team, is just for reference, we are not like in the rank. So as you can see, all teams, well, no complaints. It's perfect. It's of course different from each other, but yeah, we were really impressed. And the only one concern was no one can basically achieve the real-time performance for this task. Only, yeah, we have some experiences, make all these algorithms work really fast. But yeah, all these deep learning and feature extraction approaches were not really real-time. Okay, so this is confusion matrix for the best submission. So as you can see, almost all classes can be classified properly, except for some misclassification cases for normal Z-line and for subhagidis. Basically, subhagidis is inflammated Z-line. So it's quite easy to confuse between these classes because it's the same object, the same part of our gastrointestinal tract. It's the same for diet resection margins and diet lifted polyps because they have the same color properties because it's like colored tissue with some blue color in it. So it's not surprising. Well, and for the second goal for detection subtask, we asked the participants to use S less training data as possible. And again, surprisingly for us, with very small training data set, participants achieved very good results. So using only 1/10 of all training data set, all data set for training the system, performance is, I mean, it's very high comparing to random and yeah. Well, it's very interesting and we are looking forward to improve our task and to provide more data and to make it really multimodal and multimedia approach. So what's the main conclusions? We already achieved good performance even using these very first submissions. Yeah, small amount of training data is not a problem for medical use case, so we can easily extend our data set with new lesions, new findings, and it probably will work. Yeah, real time is should be. Yeah, real time is problem. So we should ask participants to work on this better and define like maybe new metrics and yeah, do challenge. So multi-class classification for medical images is challenging, and only small difference can should be used to define which class is it exactly. I mean, it's important to use multimodal approach. Yeah, and as we can see, medical task is kind of interesting for the community, so we are going to continue working on this. Yeah, as I said, future office task, we would like to add localization and segmentation for the medical imaging to make it even harder and make maybe to improve the task. Yeah, we are collaborating with doctors to get more data to extend our data sets even further. Yeah, introduce multimodality and multimedia in our task. And of course, we would like to finish automated report generation and make it work. Thank you. I think it's all. Yeah. And all the data sets are published, so you can just download it. It's free for research. Yeah.